my mom that first brought up the Nebraska Star Party itself. It's just a week-long event where a bunch of amateur astronomers, people from all over the states come and look at the stars. I've always had a love of astronomy and just looking up at the stars, and to have something like this in our home state is pretty astonishing. I never knew that you could drive just a few hours out of Omaha and see something like this. You just feel like you are able to do anything when you can look up at the stars and know that every single dot out there is some other solar system, possibly with another set of life forms and planets. It just helps you kind of put everything in perspective and grounds you out.
I saw the deep field image from Hubble with the 10,000 galaxies. And I looked at it and it was a cognitive dissonance moment. I was like, those are all galaxies. I was like, wow, it's just so insane. That just inspired me. I knew that's what I had to do. I knew I was meant for astronomy.
The best thing about this place is obviously the dark skies. So on the Bortle scale, it's number one. Theoretically, the darkest skies you can get. There's nothing like a completely black sky.
We're all from Northeast Illinois.
Suburbs of Chicago.
Yeah, I'm from Plainfield. You live in Bourbonnais?
Evergreen Park.
Evergreen Park.
How's the stargazing there?
You can see maybe three stars from where I live.
The stargazing there is why we're here.
If it was good there, we'd have stayed at home.
That's right. It's terrible. The dimmest star we can see on a typical night in Chicago is third magnitude. So if you can come out here and see a seventh magnitude, which is routine, then it's four magnitudes darker. That's 2.5 times 2.5 times 2. In other words, it's 40 times darker out here. And when you get 40 times darker, you can see more than 40 times as many stars. It's overwhelming.
This is the best thing you found last night.
Probably revisiting Markarian 205. That's a quasar roughly a billion light years away, if I'm remembering correctly, and it outputs the light equivalent of 1.3 billion suns.
1.3 billion suns?
Yes.
It must be an enormous object.
It probably is. It's heavy, that's for sure, because most of those are thought to have massive black holes in the middle of them.
Last night was probably the best astronomy night I've ever had, and I've been doing this 5 years.
Once the sun went down, the wind dropped, the clouds disappeared, and every star was clear. And that's a million more stars you can see than any city around here.
The Milky Way went from one horizon to the other. It was like a rainbow at night. It was just mesmerizing. I felt transported. It was the darkest sky I've ever seen.
We don't know what we're looking for. Don't know what we're looking for. We don't know what we're looking for. We don't know what we're looking for.
As a human, you should care where your origin is from, and we're all pretty much stardust. there's not much of a defining line.
the calcium in our bones and the iron in our blood came from a star. If that's not a direct connection, I don't know what is.
The more we know about ourselves and that we can expand to each other, the more love and the more energy we have, and the closer we will become to just like pure enlightenment.
We are a teaspoon of stardust. We are a million years old. We are a teaspoon of stardust.